Hello and welcome back to another episode of Uncut with Square Yards. The current pandemic situation has sort of compelled all of us to take our businesses online. The real estate sector is no different. This is exactly what we are discussing today as to how far the real estate sector has evolved as an online product. I am your host Shruti Kailash, and to discuss this, we are joined by Mr. Achal Raina, COO Raheja Developers. Thank you so much for joining us, sir, today. Welcome to the show. I want to rewind back to the year 2013-14 when we had the great online shopping festival, and I think that was the first time we had real estate as an online product. And I remember writing about it way back in 2014 that it was quite a success back then as well. The scale might differ, but what is your take on it? What, since then, 7-8 years down the line, how do you think real estate has evolved as an online product?
Okay, so as far as 2013 is concerned, my take on it is that anything which comes new obviously becomes a fad, and people have that feeling in their mind that let's try something new. So yes, participated and they felt good, and that is why some amount of results also came. However, as far as real estate is concerned, I would say that it has always been a touch and feel kind of a product or a business, where because the volume or the ticket size is not something in thousands, it's in lakhs and even crores. So anybody would feel confident going and having a visit to the site, seeing the product, coming to the company's office, understanding what exactly is the background, having that look and feel about the company, about how the office is, how many people are working, just to get that confidence in the person that, okay, fine, I'm dealing with not a fly-by-night operator, but I'm dealing with a person or a company which has a decent number of employees, a good office, a good feel factor. So, bottom line, yes, we shifted from the actual advertising in newspapers and stuff like that, but still continue. I'm not saying that it doesn't continue, but people gradually started moving towards the digital world. And it was more economic. The reach out was much more. In certain cases, I would say when we evolved over a period of time, we made it more customized to a customer. For instance, some communication is being sent to you, then it will be addressed to you, not to anybody else, which was not possible maybe in a regular ad in the newspaper, whether it is HT or TOI or whatever it is. So, it was evolution. People started moving towards digital more in terms of advertising, reaching out to more and more people. They felt that the medium is comparatively much more cheaper, and the reach out is much more in comparison to, because over a period of time, if you see, the newspapers are also getting really, really, really cluttered. Too many ads, too many these things, and a complete mix. You have FMCG, you have real estate, you have a whole lot of things which are being advertised. So it is a jumble, mumble, mumble. It's that kind of a situation. So maximum, I would say, the effect of that ad, if I see it in the morning, will actually die down. In the current situation, it will die down by the afternoon itself. Maybe earlier days, it would the recall value would be for a day or two or three, whatever. But not beyond that, okay? It got supported by the advertising which you do on the hoardings and stuff like that. So there was again a recall value, but digital became a very strong platform over a period of time. And I think moving forward, yes, that would be the platform which people would use regularly, would also improvise on it and try to make it even better, more user friendly, so that maximum amount of mileage can be you can receive from advertising on the digital platform.
So I was saying that, like you said, that digital is the way forward. But do you think in the current scenario, because of COVID, this trend has been accelerated, that you know, it has become a necessity to go online? Or do you think this was always the way forward and this would continue? It's not just
This will continue. But you are absolutely right if you say that COVID did speed up things. This would have taken maybe, you know, it is evolving over a period of time. People are finding newer ways to augment their softwares, to upgrade their softwares, to take care of the various needs. And, but COVID did, yes, absolutely did accelerate the entire process and things started moving much more faster. I was astonished myself, to tell you the truth, that it was never a situation where one thought that, you know, a customer would look at the virtual site visit and look at the product online and ultimately do a RTGS and the sales started happening. So it was, yes, initially it was kind of a shocking thing to see, but I would say I think people have adapted to this change very fast, and they also have started realizing that okay, fine, this particular situation is there to stay. One just has to take precaution and move on. So what is the best way in terms of, you know, maintaining that social distancing, doing whatever is necessary in terms of protection. So fine, let's have the digital thing. So whatever information now they want is available to them digitally. They can take virtual site visits, they can understand the product, they can see virtual photographs or live pictures of the site. In terms of development is concerned, and they get convinced that okay, fine, work is going on, the product is nice. So yes, it has been a way forward gradually, but COVID did speed up things in this entire process.
Right. So tell me one thing, like, you know, e-commerce has probably been one of the very few industries that has kind of been able to take advantage of this entire pandemic situation. You know, people are only shopping online these days. To what extent do you think the real estate sector has been able to capitalize on this? Like you spoke about the customer side getting adapted, you know, people getting adapted to the, you know, online version of real estate. But as an industry, as a developer, to what extent do you think, you know, the sector has been able to capitalize on this trend? Can you give me some numbers?
So I would have mixed comments on that. It was a gradual start.
Okay.
People tried to get used to the digital situation and doing business online.
Right.
Initially, digital platforms have always been used by more, I would say, FMCG products, consumer durable, other things. But real estate was purely utilized, I would say, for advertising or for a reach out. That,
right.
You know, digitally you reach out to a person, you start communicating with the person, electronically or digitally send him information what he requires, but it was the closure always came when there was a physical connect. You go to the office, you meet the person, understand, as I said earlier also, you see the office, get a good feel about the developer's office, about how many people are working, get impressed with that, see the product, go to the site, have a physical look at the product, see what exactly is the construction status. But actual selling, I wasn't expecting good results. But to my astonishment, I'm very, very happy with the way things are moving on. And I would say people really adapted it very, very quickly. I would give it not even months, I would give it days. 15, 20 days, people started actually responding back. And still actually started happening. So moving forward, yes, it was supposed to be digitally connecting to people and closing things. COVID did accelerate the entire thing. And I think people would adapt to this kind of a situation pretty fast.
Sure. So you mentioned that, you know, you were pleasantly surprised by the response that you got from your customers. Right. Can you give me probably if not absolute numbers, can you give me some percentages as to, you know, what was, how much of sales or how, you know, that was, how much of sales did you guys actually expect and how much conversions did you actually get? Did you actually get any conversions at all, or was it just inquiries that started pouring in online? Or could you okay. were you able to convert?
So the once we were hit by this, everybody thought we are gone, we are dead. The market is going to be dead. Nobody is going to invest. Nobody is going to come forward. So what was the next reaction? I think in the entire industry, people started throwing out people. You know, they started easing out people because they had to cut their expenses. And it was a knee-jerk kind of a reaction. And why not? I mean, you know, everybody wants to secure themselves. So jobs were lost because of the mindset, we are gone. In 15-20 days time, I would say maybe a month's time, the other action which companies took was that, okay, fine. I mean, let's try digitally, at least let's try reaching out and being there and telling people that, okay, fine, we are still there, and stay connected. That stay connected and obviously still pushing actually started getting results. So what maybe companies were thinking that, you know, it's going to be a total wipeout, there will be no sales, there will be nothing. Over a period of a year, over a period of about a month, month and a half, things started rolling back. So the expectancy of zero or maybe 20% actually started showing at about 40%, moving up to 50, moving up to 60. I would say today, I think if not 100%, we are still at a mark of about 70-75%, which is very, very good. Or rather, I would say, I would give it a band of say about 65-75% in terms of closures, in terms of actual physical closures are concerned.
Okay, so you're saying you've been actually able to achieve 60-70% closure?
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
Last quarter? Okay, that's great.
Yeah, no, absolutely. I mean, you know, I was pleasantly surprised that, The thing which I would like to point out here is that high value property, luxury property, it is more time consuming now because a person who's investing over say about 5 crores plus would like to deep dive into certain other aspects also. So if given a chance, he would like to visit the site, have a physical look at the site. But there have been closures in terms of these properties are also concerned online. Okay. Which is very, very, very good. So, for instance, I would say that if I give it a percentage in terms of the local and the people who are maybe staying outside, outside cities, or maybe, you know, somebody staying in Bombay, somebody staying in Bangalore, somebody staying in Punjab and unable to travel, they are kind of convinced digitally only. And, you know, if you show them the proper, you know, take them for a tour of the entire property, explain the property properly, but yeah, it takes a little bit of more time. But yes, there have been closures for both luxury, for a ticket size of say about 50-75 lakhs, quick closure, not a issue at all. Lesser than that, for instance, if you talk about the Noida market, 25 lakhs to say 50 lakhs, again quick closure. It is not taking that much of time, so people are adapting themselves very, very quickly, which is very good. Digital was in any case the way forward, but one could never imagine that you know, people will so my pleasant surprise is that adaptability factor and coming in so fast and people adapting it so fast is very, very encouraging, I would say.
Yes, I think we are quite used to adapting to changing situations in our lives. So like you said that, you know, this might become the new normal and people are adapting to it quite quickly. So tell me one thing, do you think that once, you know, probably we have the vaccine and once this pandemic situation is over, do you think we'll roll back to the older ways and, you know, people would want to go for the site visits and take their own sweet time to finalize, or do you think this trend would stick on?
I would say both. People by the end of the day, when this pandemic goes off, first of all, I would say, I think it is here to stay for some time. You know, even if you are able to find the vaccine in the next 3 months, 4 months time, by the time it actually reaches the masses and sure. reaches us, it will take about a year's time.
Sure.
Year's time is a fairly large time to adapt to new situations in life. I would say 70-80% things will continue the way now are, okay, or will be in the next couple of months. So people's dependency on digital platforms or they taking decisions regarding closures digitally only will continue 70-80%. But there could be a situation of still some people, say about 15-20%, who would like to again roll back to the feel and touch situation again. So, but yes, having said that, I would say because of this pandemic and the acceleration in the digital process and the adaptability, which is quite fast, and looking at a situation that, maybe it'll take us at least about a year's time, where maybe we start looking at things getting normal, people would prefer this platform to quickly close.
Sure. So finally, I just want to end it on on a note about marketing strategies. You have a background in marketing and sales. So if you could just throw some light on how are the marketing strategies for real estate sector going to be evolving in the coming years with respect to the digital transition that we've seen? Obviously, already a lot of these marketing is already happening online. Do you think or do you have any idea about what's the next in online marketing strategies? Anything specific you think?
So as I said earlier, the marketing, the digital platforms used typically by any company, if I talk about real estate companies, for marketing purposes or for awareness purpose or for lead generation. Today, with the current situation, with the pandemic coming in and people's dependence on digital platforms becoming more and more, things have changed from the perspective of actually investments going into upgradation of the software, as I said earlier also, making it more user-friendly, making it more informative for a client. And earlier, it was maybe the marketing people who were using the digital platform more than sales guys. But today, sales guys are equally using that digital platform to not only for lead generation, but to actually connect with the client and bring things to closure on a phone screen, on a video screen. So, sure. Yeah, from the perspective of digital platforms earlier being used, it was typically for marketing purposes, as I said. Now, even the sales guys have started using it regularly for their closures. And, trying to digitally connect with the client like I am talking to you right now.
Okay.
You are sitting in your office, I'm sitting here. But fine, we can talk to each other, we can understand each other. There is no need to meet physically and, across the table and sit. So, this will continue. This will continue and ultimately it will take over the way of functioning, which used to be there. So, I see in my sector, in the real estate sector, the digital platform playing a very, very important role. It has always played a very important role, but it was purely for lead generation or reaching out to the client or giving out some information or advertising and stuff like that, which from the typical advertisement in a newspaper or this and that, they graduated to digital platforms, and now the digital platforms are not purely being used by just the marketing for the marketing purposes, but also for the sales purposes.
Right, fine. Thank you so much, Mr. Achal, for joining us today. That was
a pleasure.
Discussion, and I hope we'll continue to collaborate in the future as well.
Absolutely. Looking forward.
Thank you so much. Have a great day.
Thank you. Have a good day. Have a good day.